Let's go into the night with Rick Ballew on 1010 XL 92.5 FM.
I can't find a better way to spend a Thursday afternoon than at the Miller Electric Center. Perhaps the greatest facility known to man when it comes to anything that is sports related, professionally or collegiately speaking. That is the God's honest truth. There today for lunch, a new photo, which is always a lot of fun. Then, of course, let's break some bread. Trent Baalke, Doug Peterson. Again, they just seem more comfortable as time goes on. My immediate reaction is I don't care if this football team goes 3-14. Trent Baalke's around for 2025. He is the man that is holding all the cards. And you can assume what you want. You can guess whatever it is that you want, but I feel that way today. Again, I'm even more sure of myself than I have been in the past. Regardless of what happens, Trent Baalke is going to continue to build this football team. Will Doug Peterson be around as long as Baalke? I don't know the answer to that question, but I think if there is a fall guy, it's the latter compared to the former. In a perfect world, you win, you move on, and everything is great, right? And we're all happy, and you're happy. That's the most important thing. And if it does crumble, yeah, it makes sense to just blow the whole thing up and start over. But I don't get that feeling. I just do not. All right, so it's good to have you with us. Another edition of Into the Night with Rick Ballew. Of course, 1 week from tonight, we will be a couple of hours away from the NFL draft. It's a very similar feeling, in my opinion, to Trent Baalke's first draft here in Jacksonville in 2021. Of course, he had the knucklehead alongside of him in Urban Meyer, but it ended up being a really good draft if you compare it to what they did in 2022 and 2023. And if you go back to 2019 or 2018 or any of those drafts, you look at 2021, you got Trevor the top pick, right? It was unanimous. ETN, still to this day feel like it was a, you know, it was an Urban Meyer pick. Tyson Campbell, is he next as far as a player to be re-signed? It actually really feels like the Trevor Lawrence situation could happen before the start of the regular season, which is just mind-boggling to me. It really is. I mean, let him play this year at $17.3 million. Pick up that option for next year, the fifth-year option you have until May 2nd. You know, pay the guy $25.6 million, but it does. It feels as though this thing's getting closer and closer. Baalke today talked about talking with Trevor Lawrence representatives last night. And I'm kind of in the camp of why not wait it out to make sure he's your guy. And again, I've changed in a year. You go back to this date, 2023, I was saying sign him. The sooner you sign him, the less expensive it's going to be. He's going to want to, obviously, become the highest paid player in the NFL, the highest paid quarterback in the NFL. That's market value. I mean, there's no hometown discounts. There's none of this. There's none of that. You pay the man what he's worth. We don't know if he's worth that now. Now, it'll be so easy after the fact to say, oh, you should have signed him back in April and May of 2024, right? No doubt about it, but we don't know the answer to that right now. And I will continuously bring up what is your biggest concern right now with Trevor Lawrence. He's the face of the franchise. He's a good guy. He says all the right things. He really feels like he's a team first ball player. He's made a lot of stupid plays. He's been injured. This football team hasn't had the ability to run the football as well. So there's been a lot of things that have gone against Trevor Lawrence. But anyway, it just really felt that way today listening to Trent Baalke. Back to that 2021 draft, and the reason why I raised it if you remember in 2021 when Lawrence went, then the quarterbacks went, you had a couple of corners go 8 and 9, but 8 of the top 10 players were offensive players. And that's very rare in the NFL. But if you look at all the mock drafts that are out, it's nearly unanimous. It's either 10 out of 10 or 9 out of 10 offensive players that will go 1 week from tonight, loaded at the top, again, with quarterbacks, right? And Marvin Harrison Jr., one of the three talked about wide receivers that are expected to go very high. So if Jacksonville is not in the market for the best offensive position player, not named quarterback, and it becomes a defensive player, then this is really encouraging for them with every pick that goes, especially if a fifth quarterback, whether it be Michael Penix or Bo Nix, ends up going before the Jaguars do select at number 17. We know that the four quarterbacks are going to go. Will a fifth go? That's huge. Again, positionally speaking, for this football team to line things up. So it is a similar draft this year to 2021. As far as the first round, at least that is my opinion as we get things started right here on a Thursday. Okay, thoughts from camp today. Or not camp, but thoughts from the 1 week away from the NFL draft today. They believe they're a better football team now than when they lost 5 out of their last 6, right? The only move that I would question is Darius Williams. I still thought and still do think that he had something left. And yes, I know you're going to give me on the text line, 641-1010, brought to you by Lifetime Enclosure. You're going to tell me about the obligatory switch with Ryan Nielsen and the man coverage and all of that and how Williams doesn't test well or didn't line up. And I'm aware of it, okay? I've talked about that. You've talked about that. I still think it's really the only mistake that they made as far as allowing anyone else to leave this organization. I wouldn't have paid Calvin Ridley. No way. I mean, why would you pay Calvin Ridley that amount of cash? Now, others will say, well, Blue, if you got the deal done with Josh Allen before, you could have slapped the tag on Calvin. Okay, we've been down that road as well. Time to turn the page. I'm okay with the Calvin Ridley move because he cost way too much money. And we know that Jacksonville offered. They tried to keep him here. What Tennessee gave him, frankly, was stupid. Stupid money for a guy that I just don't know if you can thoroughly trust. I mean, look at him. Look at when Calvin Ridley got to Nashville. He came right out and told the local media there, he said, honestly, I wish I was in Jacksonville. I mean, it's a weird deal. And he's a guy who's going to have to learn a totally new offense again. We knew about his struggles last year when it came to that. But he feels that this is a better team right now than he had when the season did end, what, the first weekend in January. I'd agree with that. Number two, Trent Baalke today talked about obvious needs on this football team. You don't get that a lot. If I was to rewind and listen to Baalke last year or listen to him in 2022 or listen to him in 2021, it just feels like general managers are so scared to come out and say, yeah, this is a team need. We're going to have to go in that direction. They'll tell you forever, you fill needs with what? Free agency. You draft the best available player. Every general manager, all 32 decision makers, when they meet with the local media, whether it's today, tomorrow, or early next week, or if they already have earlier in the week or whatever, they're going to tell you about their board and how their board lines up and how they're going to try to get the best possible player, the highest ranked guy on the board. You very rarely hear them admit that there are needs. Well, Baalke said that today, talking about obvious needs. So, you know, to me, it was twofold. You got a big-time need at corner. We just talked about Darius Williams. And obviously, you got a big-time hole now at wide receiver. We just talked about Calvin Ridley. There's been a lot of talk about Jacksonville packaging together this and that, right? The 17th pick, the 48th pick. Can you get up into the top 8 or 9 to get one of these three wide receivers that are head and shoulders above the others? I didn't get that feeling today. That's too much. It would cost, what, a first, a second, maybe a fifth or sixth next year. And I just don't think Balke is willing to give that up to move up, let's say, 7, 8, 9 spots somewhere in that particular area. All right? The other side of me says I wouldn't be shocked if he tried to get up ahead of Indianapolis at 15. Could he find a team to trade with at 14, at 13? Just my feeling today with this. He's not going to give everything up to move up into the top 10. So for those of you who are thinking you're going to get one of these three wide receivers, my guess is not going to happen. You're wrong. But if they really are in love with one of three guys, and I think it's got to be this at this particular point. Brian Thomas Jr., okay, 6'3", 209, a 4'3", 340, 38.5-inch vertical. I don't do a show where I don't talk about just wanting to see Trevor Lawrence with a big-bodied wide receiver like he had at Clemson, right? Really want to see that. My guess is that's probably where they will go in the second and or third round. I'm convinced that today, after what I witnessed, and again, this is just a gut. This is just a gut feel, and obviously I've spoken with a lot of people, and everyone who does this picks up the phone or texts and tries to acquire any type of information that they can. But it really feels like at this point, it's going to come down to one of these two cover corners. And the one that I know the least amount about, because he played at Toledo in Quinyon Mitchell, just feels like he's the best prospect, right? He's from this state, 6 foot, 195. He's very physical, 20 reps of 225 pounds on the bench. You read his scouting reports, and they're fairly consistent. He is a very physical football player. Loves contact, hits like a safety, can also cover like a true field corner in the National Football League. And again, 6 foot, 195. He can run a 4.33. He's got all the measurables. He's tested well. He had a spectacular Senior Bowl going up against the top wide receivers there. I think the one issue that you can look at, and it's fair, his competition on Saturday. And I haven't looked through Toledo's schedule over the last couple of years to see if they played Michigan or Ohio State. Usually those schools in that neck of the woods line up a couple of powerhouses here and there. But yes, I mean, we ended up seeing the same thing about Trevor Lawrence, for crying out loud. Trevor Lawrence ended up having, because when he was there, Florida State was down, Miami was down. Trevor Lawrence, what, had maybe 2-3 big games a year at Clemson? The ACC's been down to the point where you used to be able to just throw in that conference, any one of the Power 5 conferences, and say in conversation, yeah, he's played in big games, home and away, maybe neutral sites, college football playoff games, bowl games, whatever. Didn't really feel that way with Trevor Lawrence. It was a very simple offense under Dabo Swinney and the change of coordinators while he was there at Clemson. But it felt like, you know, Trevor really only got tested a few times a year. I don't know if that's the case with Quinyon Mitchell. Don't know. But that's where I feel this football team is going to go right here tonight. So that does beg the question, what do they love? What does Trent Baalke love right now? Who does Ryan Nielsen love right now? Who does Doug Peterson love right now? I've said all along, I would address offense, 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 offense. If I was picking, I wouldn't go near Arnold or Mitchell, simply because I still believe there's too many holes in this football team. You can never have enough offensive linemen. They need a big-bodied wide receiver. At 17, I go with one of those two picks. That's where I go. But I am convinced, at least for the time being, after listening to Baalke today and Peterson, that's not where they're going to go. And it becomes a test now, and really, the love that they have for either Terrion Arnold or Quinyon Mitchell, is there a noticeable difference in the work that they've done? We can look at all these mock drafts. I'm going to have a guest joining me in 15 minutes who's going to give us the very latest. You hear him all the time on our radio station. You read about it all over. everyone's got an opinion. Who does Trent Baalke like? What have his scouts provided for him? The input, the people that he trusts, including the newly acquired, once again, Tom Gamble, who's been with Trent Baalke a few times in his career, just wrapped up winning a national championship at Michigan under Jim Harbaugh. You know, he's back in the stable here. Gamble's a very highly thought of guy. I don't know if he's going to change their way of thinking with their pick a week from tomorrow night. And I guess he's been here since like mid-February. So he's been around for a little bit. He's been here for about 2 months. Baalke didn't know the exact date when he was asked about it earlier today. But obviously, that's a very good thing to say. You know, my guess is his staff, yes. But there's not a whole heck of a lot of people that Trent Baalke trusts to the point where it could have an effect on his decision. Does that make any sense? I'm not saying he didn't have friends throughout the league or guys that he hangs his hat with or all that type of stuff. I'm talking about this could influence his decision. How many guys are, I mean, the guys under him, his scouts, pro player personnel, assistant general manager, Ethan Waugh, all those guys, sure, their input is very important. The input of Doug Peterson, very important. Newly acquired Ryan Nielsen, very important. But it's still Baalke's decision. And this isn't the top pick where we were told that it was going to be Shad Khan who would eventually, you know, have the final say on Trevor Lawrence. Look at the criticism a year later when it was Walker over Hutchinson. There's still people in this city that are uptight about that. This is the norm. I think this is league-wide. When you have that ego, when you have that position of being able to simply say, okay, thank you, but I'm not going in that direction. I am picking this player, and this is the reason why. My guess is general managers, there's only a few guys under their umbrella that could persuade, if you will, a change with their top pick. So we'll see. What we're trying to find out, what's going on, okay? Is it Terrion Arnold, 6 foot, 189, 4'5", very good athlete, very good athletically speaking, doesn't run like Quinyon Mitchell. He's not as physical as Mitchell. He doesn't have a vertical jump like Mitchell, but he's a guy who's been tested at 2 years at LSU. Right? A guy who went up against neighbors, a guy who went up against Brian Thomas Jr., a guy who went up against top talent week in, week out at Alabama. They'll tell you if you have the measurables and you can play, sure, there's a learning curve, but you go out and you draft them anyway. How much does experience really matter when you're talking about two guys who on Saturday were in completely different stadiums? Arnold, under the microscope, week after week after week after week, playing the best competition in college football. A year ago at this point, I didn't even know who Quinyon Mitchell was. And my guess is that most of you out there didn't know who he was as well. But that's where I believe they're going. One of those two picks, and I do think there is a chance we'd talk about the Colts right there ahead of them, whether it's DB or wide receiver, that the Colts could grab the guy that Jacksonville wants. I look at the Broncos at 12. There's some similarities there with Denver, possibly ticking the guy that Jacksonville could want. So that's what I got out of it today. I thought it was an interesting conversation with both. Certainly thank them for being available. And that's where I am at this particular time. So as always, I'm going to give you the opportunity to voice your opinion, 641-1010. Brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures on our text line. The other thing that I got out of this was it really does feel like this Trevor Lawrence extension is going to take place. Now, let me say this. If they're trying to get a deal done and they believe they can get a deal done, what that says is they've got the guy. They need to make changes around for him to be better. But they've got the guy. And right now, it just feels like one problem after another, starting with you don't know who's going to call plays. Trevor was asked about it on Tuesday. We don't know. Now, Doug Peterson doesn't have to make up his mind on April 18th, but we don't know who's going to call plays. And again, there's been speculation that Trevor doesn't want press to call plays. I don't know that. I don't know if that's the case. I've heard it. I think everyone who covers the team has heard it. Doesn't mean it's true, right? For all we know, that never could have come out of the mouth of Trevor Lawrence. Matter of fact, if it did, don't you kind of get the feeling that he'd no longer be here? I mean, I don't think anyone out there would be really upset if during the day in which Mike Caldwell and that defensive staff was let go, along with some offensive coaches, if you found out that Press Taylor was no longer here, I think you would have been all right with it. I think most were like, you got to be kidding me. Totally underwhelming, totally predictable. I wasn't as hard on Press as others, okay? But so, again, that's speculation. But if they were to make this move and get the deal done now, that ends all talk. That ends everything as far as he's got to prove it this year. He's looking over his shoulder. When are you going to pay him? Dare I say, what if Trevor Lawrence acted like a lot of these other quarterbacks and came out and said, that's it, pay me or I'm not going to show up? Imagine what it would be like in this city if anything like that was spoken. And it hasn't been spoken. Trevor says all the right things. You want to like the guy. He's a likable human being. He appears to be a very good human being, right? They've got to do a better job around him, and he's got to do a better job as the leader of this franchise. He can't keep making stupid mistakes. He can't do it. Enough is enough is enough. He made too many last year, and the feeling is he's trying to make a play. Mm-mm. He can't anymore. So he has that going against him, the play calling going against him, the fact that they can't run the football going against him, and the fact that when it comes to a big-bodied wide receiver, they haven't really had it. Last year, we know as well, Christian Kirk was out, Zay Jones was out. Calvin Ridley did not step up when those two were not playing. Calvin Ridley was not a 1A wide receiver. It feels like this organization doesn't have a true number one wide receiver. They're paid like him. And I think we will all agree that Kirk is the most important piece to this offense, not named Trevor Lawrence. It wasn't Calvin Ridley. And number two is Evan Engram. So that's where I am now after listening to these gentlemen a little bit earlier this afternoon. For what it's worth, it doesn't change the way I think, okay? I would not give Trevor Lawrence a contract extension right now. I would not. I wouldn't. I don't think he's earned it. I don't think you hurry up where the collective bargaining agreement put in order 5 years for first-round rookies. You can pick up a team option by May 2nd that'll pay him just over $26 million next year. And obviously this year he's playing for $17 million. All right? And I understand the logic. Well, if you get it done now, it'll be cheaper down the road. I still want to see it. Don't you? I mean, don't you want to see it again with your eyes? Are you 100% sold on the fact that this man is the guy to lead this organization for the next 4 or 5 years down the road? I hope so. But we haven't seen it. The evidence is not there at this particular time. So I'm in no hurry to get this deal done. But it really felt like they are close. And to credit the organization and to credit Trent Baalke, if they get a deal done and Trevor hits it out of the yard and all of a sudden he eliminates those stupid plays, the football team is able to keep him healthy. He told us what, Tuesday? It took him until mid-March until he was healthy. Then the situation with this football team turns 180 degrees because you have your quarterback set for years and years and years and years down the road. I think Baalke's done a wonderful job with the cap. He could still restructure some deals here. He could restructure Robinson. He could restructure Kirk. He still has an opportunity to grow more money. But anyway, that's what I got out of it this afternoon. As always, I do invite your opinion. 641-1010 is the best way for you to get on in on our text line brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures. All right, Shmunez Vision, big fan of them, as always. Whenever it comes to your eyes, I mean, it's so incredibly important. First off, check them out online or check them out on Instagram. It's pretty hip. The testimonials are cool. And I'd like you to get that opportunity to look at Shmunez Vision on Instagram. But regardless of what it is when it comes to your eyes, you need to be able to trust a family in town, right? A practice in town that's been around for quite some time and one that really continues to thrive. It's why people go out of their way to find them. It's about special care. And I'll tell you that. There's no doubt. Some of these can be rackets. No matter what the situation is, you know, let's get them in, get them out. You know, it's almost like working at a convenience store when you get a Diet Mountain Dew 64-ounce draft and maybe a Slim Jim. The cashier's like, what? Let's get them in and get them out. Well, there's a lot of people like that in every single profession. Instead of sitting back and giving you the care that you need. 8.5 years ago, I went in. Bam. You need surgery the next morning. I'm like, what? I feel fine. My eyes are fine. No, it's not. Cancerous, removed by Dr. Neil Shmunez. There's never been a setback. Whenever I go and visit, everything is spectacular. Check them out online. That is your best bet. Just go to Shmunez Vision. Care you can see, Shmunez Vision. All right, rest in peace, Dickie Betts. Have a lot on him coming up over the next couple of hours. Also, let's crank up the NFL draft. It's 1 week from tonight. 1 week from tonight. Ryan Roberts is on deck. Love his draft coverage. He goes into the night with Rick Ballew.
This is Barry Sanders.
Sanders still on his feet, and Sanders is gone.
Jacksonville Sports Radio.
1010XL.
Hold on tight, because All Pro Roofing is unleashing some electrifying news. Brace yourselves for instant excitement. Instant roof quotes are here. Simply surf over to their website and hit the Instant Roof Quote tab. Boom! That's your ticket to a lightning-fast estimate. Head over to allproroofingllc.com. Click that Instant Roof Quote tab. What are you waiting for? Click on the Instant Roof Quote tab today at allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132-7056.
CDC 060-138.
Splish, splash, I'm taking up.
Everything okay in here?
Oh, yeah, sure is.
You're wearing a life jacket.
Sure am.
In the tub?
Practicing for when we head to the lake. I read about wearing one at wearitflorida.com.
And wearitflorida.com told you to wear it in the tub?
Nope, that was my idea. You know, Florida is the leader in boating fatalities, so a life jacket can save lives.
As you were.
Splish, splash, I was taking a
Learn
bath.
More at wearitflorida.com.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
Certainly facing challenging economic times, I can't speak for all of us, but for me, comforting to know my money is in good hands with ITP Partners. Ticket here for ITP Partners, Jacksonville guys, taking care of my Jacksonville money. I'll admit it, I don't understand a ton about the economy, higher interest rates, 401ks, but I do know as I move closer to retirement, I continue to watch my money grow. Thanks to Chris Bryan, Jeff Hartman, Reagan Wright, Dan Abel, and Reed Wingate. Get in the game, guys. ITP Partners, always there to help. For more info, Chris at ITPPartners.com or call 904-312-9751.
Start your Saturday with a whiff of the great outdoors.
Captain Kevin Favor here with Captain Kirk and Jeff Loggeman. We bring you the fresh air of the great outdoors.
On the Nimnet Outdoor Show. Presented by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing and Septic Services on 1010XL.
It's tune-up time, and Florida Home AC, the official AC partner of the Jaguars, wants to partner with you for a cool summer season. Tune up your AC unit right now so it's running at peak performance when you need it most. Just call 777-4300 and order a tune-up for just $59. Keep your unit humming at optimal level. Log on to floridahomeac.com and take advantage of their savings. Keep cool with Florida Home AC. That's 777-4300.
Looking for a new or used firearm? Beaches Jewelry and Pawn in Jacksonville Beach will get you locked and loaded. New firearms coming in weekly and always looking for used guns. No lines and no waiting. Online at beachesjewelryandpawn.com.
This is Hayes Carline for SkyLife Elite. Are you tired of canceled flights, unruly passengers, and layovers? Call my friends at SkyLife Elite. Consider using private charter flights for your next adventure. Yes, you can afford it. Make your own schedule. Fly direct. Drive your car to Craig Airport and get directly on the plane. SkyLife Elite can make that happen. Call 490-9332, go to flyskylife.com, and find them on social media. Fly SkyLife Elite, North Florida's premier private air charter.
I can't believe tax season is here already. But look at all this info I have to enter.
Phil's small accounting firm is growing in numbers.
Why didn't I take that typing class in high school?
A data entry specialist could really help him in a crunch.
I got blisters on my fingers!
Indeed can help him hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
If you're a business owner and want to learn about federal, state, or local government contracts, plan to attend a free online webinar April 23rd. The Florida Apex Accelerator, in partnership with UNF, provides expert guidance and consultations at no cost. The Apex Accelerator program can make selling to the government less complicated. To attend the free Coffee and Contracting webinar April 23rd, register at unf.edu/SBDC. Then select Training and Event tab.
If you are having problems related to selling your home, here's your solution. You just have not discovered ChadAndSandy.com. That's ChadAndSandy.com. Listen, maybe the problem is you need more space for your office or growing family, or perhaps you're worried about settling for less money with a lowball instant offer. We've got one guarantee here that always rings true. Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. It's as simple as that. So you need to call 904-414-6200 or go to chadandsandy.com like Jonathan in Mount Pleasant did. The only thing standing between me and my dream of traveling in my RV was the sale of my Mount Pleasant home. I heard Chad and Sandy on the radio and called. Crazy results. In just 3 days, I received multiple offers for full asking price. So you don't have the problems you think you do. You have solutions and promises with Chad and Sandy. Go to chadandsandy.com or call 904-414-6200. 6200 at chadandsandy.com.
Test your aim to help local kids succeed. It's the 6th annual Mackenzie Noel Wilson Foundation Clay Shoot to support the Boys and Girls Clubs of Northeast Florida and Mackenzie's Camp Deep Pond Thursday, May 30th at Jack's Clay Target Sports. Get your team and the Boys and Girls Club take care of the rest. Ammo, cart, clays, breakfast bites, lunch, and goodies. Proceeds benefit 56 area clubs serving over 5,200 area kids every day. Go to bgcnf.org/events.
1010XL is presented by Barra and Farah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
There's a lot, as you know, that goes into it. You know, we feel good about the group that's there, you know, at different positions, you know, that we're focused in on a little bit. But you don't know what's going to happen. You know, you really aren't going to know what we're going to do until maybe the 12th or 13th pick. You know, and then we'll look at the opportunity to potentially move up. You know, and if we get to 16 like we did last year, and somebody calls and there's a chance to move back one or two. You know, you just don't know. It's you're playing it on game day.
Trent Baalke, a little bit earlier today, opportunity to meet with him and head coach Doug Peterson. They did move up a couple years ago for Devin Lloyd, right? But Baalke, for the most part, both in San Francisco and here in Jacksonville, known to go the other way and trade where you acquire more picks. So we'll see. I really got a sneaky suspicion. Something could happen 1 week from tonight. Ryan Roberts does an outstanding job covering the NFL draft with RiseAndDraft.com and a frequent guest here with Rick Ballew. Ryan, I appreciate a few minutes. I know you're a busy human being.
Oh, I appreciate you for having me back on, Rick. How's everything going?
Everything with me is fantastic. You know, today I just said to my listeners, I got the feeling that you know, this talk, Jackson will package everything, move up into the top 8 or 9 to get one of these wide receivers. My feeling is no, but could they move up 2, 3, 4 spots to maybe get the highest coveted corner in this year's draft class? I really think, Ryan, there's an opportunity that this organization may do that.
Yeah, I could definitely see the vision. I would even say, though, if because I'm thinking to wide receiver for a second, right? I know your question is about corner, but I even think of it simply as if there's a run on wide receivers early, like let's say there's two that go, Marvin Harrison Jr., Malik Nabers in the top 5 to 6 picks, you know, and there, obviously we look at the Chicago Bears right now at number 9 as a team that is going to be in the wide receiver market. Like if you get to that point and sometime after pick 10 and obviously before 17, if you want to jump up and make sure you can get a Brian Thomas Jr., you know what mm-hmm. I mean? To make sure that you can capitalize on that run and make sure that you don't miss out on wide receiver 4. I mean, that's a possibility. Cornerback's a really interesting one because you might be able to have your pick of the litter if that's kind of, you know, if that's your initiative here, right? Because I think that there's going to be an early run on quarterbacks, obviously. We've been talking nauseam about that. There's a possibility that at least 2 offensive tackles go in the top 10. We're talking about a wide receiver or 2 potentially in the top 6 to 7 picks. If all that happens, we could be staring, you know, in the preteens and into the, you know, early teens with maybe your pick of whether you want Terrion Arnold or Nate Wiggins or, you know, whatever your pick or Quinyon Mitchell, like whoever your flavor is at corner, that might be a good possibility. And if that's obviously, I know the Jaguars, you know, had a little bit of a down year with Tyson Campbell battling through some stuff. I know that they lost Darius Williams, went back to L.A. this offseason as well. So if you just want to strengthen that position and make sure that you get the top corner off the board, that might be an opportunity that you have, and you wouldn't have to mortgage too much, obviously, just go up a couple picks.
Yeah, and if they were able to do that, I wonder what the asking price is. I mean, to get in the top 10, it's going to take a 17 and 48 and probably yep. a fifth rounder, maybe next year or whatever. What is it going to cost to move up a few spots? That's mm-hmm. is just as intriguing to me, Ryan, because, you know, I don't think they can afford to give up 2 quality picks for 1 player unless they just love that football player. Because last year's picks, yeah. second, third round, were fringe picks. I mean, they picked a backup running back. They picked a backup tight end, 2 guys who really disappointed, didn't do anything as rookies. They may flourish this year and year 2, but they didn't last season. They can't make that same mistake this year. They got to get a guy at 17, a guy at 48 who can come in and, if not be a starter, certainly be a major contributor to this year's club.
Well, and I almost wonder, you know, off of that thought process, that if you're getting close to 17, like, I'll put it this way. Like, you can move up a couple spots, potentially get your pick. Maybe you have to give up a 3rd or a future 2nd. Like, I don't know what the asking price would be as far as an exchange to go up into, like, you know, let's say 12 or 13, mm-hmm. whatever the number is there. But I think that it's a really interesting opportunity for corner, just kind of thinking back to that, because if you're sitting there at 48, you're going to get a really good player. I mean, like, at wide receiver, I mean, right?
Yeah.
I think we talked about it last time I was on.
Right.
That I am on the advantage of I would target corner in the first round for the Jacksonville Jaguars, because I think that the cornerback spot is a little bit top-heavy. And if you ask me, like, are you more likely to get a top player at wide receiver at 48 or a top corner at 48, my answer would easily be wide receiver in this class. You know what I mean? So
yes.
I think if they're targeting corner in the first round, 48, I mean, might be able to get a Keon Coleman, might be able to get a Ladd McConkey. I mean, there's going to be a lot of good options there at 48, I think, for a wide receiver.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And, you know, I would agree with that. Now, if they could get someone special, if you knew that it was going to be a Chase – or it was going to be a Lamb or a Jefferson or a guy like right. that, then I can see packaging these moves and make a move up. But, you know, and I understand that trends mean nothing if you're talking about a new front office and a new head coach, but Jacksonville has never drafted well at wide receiver. It's been an abomination in the first round. And, you know, I asked Trent about the draft 3 years ago today, so I know he's not even thinking about that, but I'll tell you what, Jaguar fans are.
Oh, no doubt, no doubt. And again, I think that you have to take advantage of where the depth points are in this class. You know, like I know that this time of year especially, you know, every person that's listening to a radio, everyone that's listening to a mainstream draft analyst, they just want to know about those first rounders. You know what I mean? Like those guys that are the foregone top 32 and what the board's going to look like, and they want to see Mel Kiper's first round mock. And I totally get it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I think ultimately when we're talking about how teams are built, I mean, when you look at the percentage of guys that are day three picks on a roster, PFAs on a roster, I mean, the hit rate, I mean, you have to be able to really take advantage of depth of certain spots, right? So I think wide receivers, especially one that I just keep coming back to, I mean, forget about 48. I mean, there's – because where Jacksonville is right now, you have a couple who I consider at least a wide receiver – producers, you know, as far as like Christian Kirk can produce in the right role. Zay Jones can produce in that role. You know, you brought in Gabe Davis, who was a disappointment for Buffalo, but you don't need him to be what you want, what Buffalo tried to make him be the last couple years. Like, he just needs to be a departmentalized role. And if you're able to do that and find another guy that fits, I think that that's the proposition, right? But I think that I would anticipate, and you can correct me if I'm wrong here, but Jaguars fans are probably in the movement of, we need to get Trevor another weapon because we don't want to waste this rookie contract window if we have one. Like, that's kind of how it feels like to me as an outsider.
No doubt about it. Talking with Ryan Roberts with RiseAndDraft.com, the NFL draft 1 week from tonight. I've said it all along. If I had any say, which obviously I don't, I would draft the biggest wide receiver, the best wide receiver in this draft class, or another offensive lineman. That is where I believe this football team has to be. You can't build everything at once. And, you know, 2 years ago, this team in consecutive years was selecting at number one. They've been 9-8 the last couple of years. It's a much better starting point, but I would stay with offense. However, I'm convinced that they're going defense and they're going cornerback. So is there a, in your analysis, the guy that I keep going to is the one that I know the least amount of because he played at Toledo, but you know, the video that I've seen and everything I've read, there really isn't a weakness for Quinyon Mitchell outside of the fact that has he faced enough stiff competition on Saturday?
Right. Yeah. So the thing with Quinyon, and I remember actually scouting him for the first time 2 years ago, he had a 3-interception game. I can't remember who it was. It was a MAC team though, where he just kind of showed impressive ball skills, really good change of direction and off man. Like, it was a really impressive show. And the last 2 years, I mean, just kept stacking, right? Like, good game after good game, production after production. Like, he was just fantastic for Toledo. And those concerns were certainly on the table. You know, like, what is he going to do against SEC-level talent, against, obviously, NFL talent? Like, what's he going to look like? Well, fortunately for Quinyon, he went down to the Senior Bowl, and he was the best player on the field on either side all week of practice. Like, he was the best player, in my opinion, there.
Mm-hmm.
He was, I mean, whether he was against North Carolina receivers, USC, like, it didn't matter. He was the best player out there. And then he went to the combine, and if you want to, you know, prove that a guy can jump a competition, well, you go to the combine, you run 4.3 something and have a 40-inch vert, right? Like, those things kind of translate pretty dang well. So, a long answer to say, I think Quinyon's an excellent football player. I would draft him definitely in the top 20. I would consider him in the top 15. I think he has potential to be a high-level corner on the next level. The only concern that you have, because he's incredible from off man, has really good ball skills, the only thing that you can really poke his hole in, and I don't know enough about the Jaguars' defensive system as far as what they want to do from a coverage variation perspective, but he didn't play much press at Toledo. Like, he was a off man, I'm a better athlete than you, change direction, flip your hips, run with anybody. He wasn't a guy that was used in press. Now, he's tall, he's long, he's strong. So I look at him and I say, you can be good in press, I think, but you didn't really get a sample size of it, right? So that's the only concern really with Quinyon. Athletically, he can do it. Every step of the process was fantastic throughout. I think he'll be a really good player. But if you're a press man heavy team, that's the only spot that I have to say it's a little bit of projection to the next level.
And that's legit. I mean, and that's something that boils my blood all the time. You look at Trayvon Walker 2 years ago. He played three different positions on the line at Georgia. And, you know, I thought he was going to be on the edge, hand in the ground, go rush the quarterback. And then we found out, you know, right during rookie minicamp 2 years ago, he's working out with Bill Shuey. He's going to be an outside linebacker. Last year they get Anton Harrison, 23 starts, 22 at left tackle. He's going to be your right tackle. I mean, it's amazing that this organization 3 years ago didn't put Trevor Lawrence at tight end, for crying out loud. I mean, so now, you like this Mitchell kid, but he's not a press. He hasn't had a lot of reps in man coverage. So, I mean, that becomes, again, is that a little bit of a roll of the dice, or do you believe in Ryan Nielsen's system, Arnold's a better get, Nate Wiggins is a better get? Do you have a thought on that?
I mean, I think a couple players that have proven that they're press man system corners. You mentioned one, Tyrion Arnold. Alabama asked that those guys to do it all the time. So, like, Kool-Aid McKinstry, in my opinion, is probably the best technical press man corner in this draft. Now, I don't think his athletic upside is as much as his teammates Arnold. I don't think it's as much as Quinion Mitchell's. I also don't think it's as much as Nate Wiggins. But he is a player that has played a lot of press. Arnold's played less press than Kool-Aid, but he's played a good amount. And then you mentioned Nate Wiggins, who – Nate Wiggins needs to get stronger. Like, he needs to fill out his frame. But for a guy that's only 170-something pounds right now, his play strength in the pass game is pretty good. Now, he needs to improve as a tackler and a run support and all those things. But in the passing game, he competes through the catch point. He's pretty good at the line of scrimmage. So those guys are definitely more proven press man corners. I just think it comes down to, I'm a big believer, and I know this isn't always the case, but I'm a big believer, if you're a coach worth anything, you play to your player strengths. You know, like, you don't make square pegs fit in round holes. You maximize what they do best. So if they're a heavy press man system, but you think that Quinion Mitchell is the best player on the board, I personally would just draft the talent, and then hopefully my defensive coordinator is able to figure it out. I know that's a tall ask for some, but I do think the best coaches are ones that maximize their players' talent, and they change, well, I don't want to say change things, but they put in wrinkles and they make little alterations to best fit their player.
Final moment with Ryan Roberts, covers the NFL draft with riseanddraft.com. You can get him as well on Twitter. It is a great follow. Okay, Tavondre Sweat, Texas. Is he getting red flagged across the league, or do you think he's going to – all it takes is one team to say, well, yeah, 366 pounds, eat space in the middle, we'll take him.
Yeah, I mean, it always does take one. It's a super cliche, but it does. I personally do think that they're going to dock him a little bit. I mean, I don't think it's going to be like a two-round drop or anything. It's probably more like a half a round, maybe a round, you know. So if he's – and I didn't ever actually buy the first-round hype. I thought he was more of a second-round type of player. So maybe he goes mid-second, maybe he goes late-second. Like, he's still going to be a top 64 pick more than likely, though, because like you said, I mean, you just don't have guys that – can do what he does in the run game. I mean, he can patrol. Like, he really is a very good player against the run, and he actually had some decent pass rush production considering he is a true nose, you know what I mean? So I think he's still going to get drafted really high. I think the thing that hurts him is it's not just a one-off incident that happened. It's the fact that, and I think Dane Brugler from The Athletic put this out, and I think that Dane does a tremendous job, and he had said that, you know, before this, or actually during this draft process, one thing that teams kept asking Tavondre Sweat about is that he's had kind of the past of underage drinking and partying and all that type of stuff, right? And he was, like, very forthcoming and would be open about it. But then after you're forthcoming open about it and saying that, you know, you've kind of been on the right path and you've remedied the past a little bit, then that happens, right? Mm-hmm. So I think some teams are going to look at that as a little bit of a red flag of, like, hey, dude, like, you were upfront about this. But when you're upfront about something, you need to show that you are making growth in that area. So I think it's going to knock him down a little bit. I don't think it's going to be anything drastic. I just think it's probably a little bit of a maturity thing for him.
Yeah. Hey, last one for you. Brandon Ayuk, T. Higgins. Do you expect a lot of trades 1 week from tonight?
I expect a couple. Not a ton. I think Ayuk, even though there's been a lot of back and forth and there's been some false rumors and his agents kind of saying, like, you know, they don't want to leave and all that type of stuff. Like, I wouldn't be shocked if Ayuk moves at some point, maybe during the draft. I mean, it's very possible. I think Higgins is going to just play this year and then kind of figure it out from there type of thing. So I expect a little bit of movement, but I don't think it's going to be anything outrageous. I think more than likely the movement that we're going to see is going to be draft pick capital for draft pick capital more than players.
Should be a lot of fun. That is 1 week from tonight. Make sure you get everything from Ryan Roberts. Just go on Twitter and RX, Ryan Roberts, Rise and Draft, and does a great job covering the NFL, and we appreciate it. Ryan, always a lot of fun. Thank you, man. We'll do it again.
Absolutely, brother. Thank you as always for having me.
There he goes, Ryan Roberts. Good stuff there. Interesting. Boy, his best man cover is Kool-Aid McKinstry, who, you know, for the most part, is projected as probably a second-round pick, maybe late first-round pick, not nearly as high as his teammate, Tyrion Arnold, or Quinion Mitchell. So we'll see what ends up happening. But Yeah, that I don't know how this is with the other 31 teams, right? But it just seems like forever around here, they very rarely draft a guy and play him at the position he played in college. Josh Allen, not the same position. Miles Jack, they moved him all over. Hell, there was even talk that Jalen Ramsey was going to play free safety when they drafted him. And, you know, we saw Harrison, and now it's their full-time job, right? There should be accountability that life is not perfect. And, yes, if you were a left tackle, now you're a right tackle. Or if you never played press man cover, you played zone, all right, you got to learn that. But it would also be kind of cool to bring in someone and say you're a starter and you're now at a position that you played at while you were in college. And that was the case in the 2021 draft with several of these guys, Trevor Lawrence and Travis Etienne. Although they didn't really use Etienne in 2021 the way that they should have. He didn't catch a lot of balls. He caught a ton at Clemson. Now, he did last year. He nearly doubled his intake in receptions in year two for Travis Etienne, which was really year three, but we know what happened to him as a rookie. You know, Tyson Campbell, okay. Nice job there. Walker Little, holy freaking Toledo. Has this organization ever screwed over Walker Little? I mean, they used a third-round pick on him. It's unbelievable. Actually, they used the second-round pick on Walker Little. The guy missed time at Stanford with an injury. He's a left tackle. That's my prime example of this. They tried and tried and tried and tried to make him a right tackle. He's not. They tried to slide him inside at left guard. He's not. You used a very high draft pick. Man, it was the 65th pick. Actually, it was the 45th pick in the draft, in the second round. Second round pick after Tyson Campbell. And they missed massively on that. If there's one example, you know, it looks like it's going to work with Anton Harrison, which is very promising. But boy, did they screw up some of this other stuff. I mean, feel free to go out and draft a guy at a position he's played. But that's why they get paid the big bucks, right? To be able to figure this out. And don't tell me they've played only zone. We'll make them man-to-man, press corners, now under Ryan Nielsen. Good stuff there. Thank you to Ryan Roberts. Always appreciate his time when he gets to join us right here on 1010XL and 92.5 FM. All right, tonight's show brought to you by Patriot Roofing Services, specializing in all types of commercial, residential roofing and repairs, gutters, sun tubes, skylights. Give my buddy Mark Tozzolo a call, 982-4052. If you need a brand new roof for your business or home, or your current roof needs repairs, just go to Patriot Roofing. No subcontractors. You're dealing with only Mark, licensed and insured. So, again, give him a call today, or better yet, just check him out online. Go to Patriot Roofing Services. We have much more to do. The best way for you to get on in is on the text line. That number is 641-1010. And it's brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures.
Get gear grinding, asphalt winding NASCAR on 1010XL.
This is going to be tight right here.
This Sunday at Talladega, brought to you by the Plumbers and Pipefitters Local Union 234 on your NASCAR station, 1010XL.
Big Brothers Big Sisters is teaming up with the NFL to inspire change. From now to draft day, Big Brothers Big Sisters is following the NFL draft, aiming to recruit potential bigs. Hi, I'm Brent from the 1010 sales team. I'm committed as a mentor, and we need you to step up and become a mentor too. There's a waiting list of more than 50 children hoping for a mentor. It's just a few hours a month. Be a mentor. Become a big. Visit bbbsnefl.org. Be a mentor or visit Big Brothers Big Sisters and click on Big Draft.
Life isn't the same without live music. Players Grill Mandarin has Samuel Sanders performing covers and original music this Saturday at 8 p.m. Jam out with this local singer-songwriter while enjoying tasty food everyone can enjoy. Players Grill Mandarin, where the neighborhood meets.
Baloo for Shinatry Chiropractic. They've helped me get rid of my headaches and pain in my neck and back. Are you suffering from an auto accident? What about TMJ pain? Headaches associated with jaw clenching, grinding of the teeth, or stress-related disorders? Shinatry Chiropractic has a physical therapist on staff for rehabilitation, quality chiropractic care, dry needling massage, and acupuncture. Call 743-6700 or go to shinatrydc.com.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 18th, 2017, soccer star Cristiano Ronaldo becomes the first player to score 100 goals in the Championship League.
Hey folks, Mike Dempsey here. You've heard me talking about Pella windows and doors, and with great ratings and expert reviews, you know they're high quality and energy efficient products. So what's your next step? How about scheduling a free consultation or just stop by the Pella showroom right there on Phillips Highway next to Tesla? Pella's professional consultants will guide you through your entire project from start to finish. From simple projects to complex renovations, their team has the experience needed to make your project a success. And that's the quality and service you can expect from Pella Windows and Doors.
Let's go!
Looking for a night of action without a big hit to your bankroll? This Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena, cheer on your Sharks as they go all in against the Las Vegas Nighthawks. See what I did there? With tickets as low as $15, you can't find this kind of family, affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com.
Let's go!
Decades night. Find that old members-only jacket or favorite flannel shirt. We're celebrating the 90s. What's your favorite decade?
Let's go!
Don't miss the fun this Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena. For tickets, call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com. That's tickets at 904-621-0700.
Let's go! Let's go!
Hey sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Look, we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino canceled because real life came calling. Well, MyBookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action, all from the comfort of your own home. I love the live casino. The roulette is awesome. It's so easy and so much fun. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find live dealers ready to deal or spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience when the action is in your hands. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL and a revamped loyalty program ensures a host of exclusive VIP perks. So sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win. Only with MyBookie.
Ah, the sun's out, the water's cool. It's a perfect day for boating.
What's that boat doing?
Perfect boating days can quickly turn into disasters when drugs and alcohol are involved. Don't let boating under the influence ruin your day. FWC officers have zero tolerance for impaired operators. If you're over the limit, you're under arrest. Learn more at myfwc.com. Brought to you by the FWC Division of Law Enforcement.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free from credit cards, car loans, and personal loans. Hey, Prosser here. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards. Get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508, or go to loanpronto.com. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Rest in peace, Dickie Betts.
Walk along the river, sweet lullaby. It just keep on flowing. And don't worry about where it's going. Oh, no.
He wrote this in 71 about his girlfriend at the time. I guess she was crazy from Canada. And, of course, those who remember Eat a Peach, this was really it for Dwayne. He died right around the completion of the album, but, you know, Dickie and Dwayne together, the two guitars, and as many know, there were others who came in, but certainly Derek Trucks for 16 years played alongside Dickie Betts and the Allman Brothers. And Dickie was in and out. Dickie had some health problems, as we know. But he didn't get recognized, I think, enough for his lyrics, you know, as a lyricist and as well as a song singer, right? I mean, you think of Greg Allman all the time. And I was actually reading about this a lot earlier today. Apparently, Dickie Betts was like, Greg, you sing it. And Dwayne was like, no, no, no. Dickie, you wrote it. We want you to sing it. And, of course, he sang Rambling Man. And I don't know, just a legend. Had a stroke a few years ago, but he is dead today at the age of 80. The great Dickie Betts. Rest in peace. Your music will live forever. No doubt about it. I remember when they kicked off here a couple of years ago. I think was it year one or it might have been year two that Tedeschi Trucks were playing over at Daly's place. That is the day that Greg Allman died. And they had to go on stage. And I know it was very difficult for Derek. But the Dickie Betts stories are sensational. There's some that are just priceless that I've been fortunate enough of being on the receiving end and hearing some of them from Derek and Susan, just phenomenal. And again, 80 years of age, but he's really dealt with some tough times as of late. So he did pass a little bit earlier today, I guess out in Osprey, Florida, after being born and raised in West Palm Beach. You an Allman Brothers guy, or is that a little bit before your time?
Well, it's certainly before my time, but I love the Allman. That's my mom's favorite group.
Oh, really?
And, yeah, just always grew up listening to the Allman Brothers, just being on every Southern rock station, you know, growing up listening to them. Yeah, so I would say Jessica's probably my favorite song. I just love it. It's like 8 minutes of no lyrics whatsoever, jam sesh. But, yeah, all of them.
Jessica named after one of his, he had four children.
I thought you were going to say four wives.
But it was named after one of his daughters, Jessica. Okay. Yeah, I love that song as well. There's no doubt about it. You know, I grew up classic rock and everything, but there wasn't a ton of Southern rock in Boston.
I could imagine that.
I think in my opinion, Lynyrd Skynyrd was number one. I always looked at Creedence as Southern rock. It's not Southern rock. It's tree-hugging rock. It's Haight-Ashbury and Ashbury. It's the tail end of the free spirit, free love, and the hippie movement. I mean, it came like right out of Berkeley. But it sounds swampy, right? Creedence Clearwater Revival sounds
Swamp music.
Yeah, the band sounded swampy. The band is Canadian, crying out loud. But the Allman Brothers, there was a little bit of a taste of that. And then maybe some Charlie Daniels. And that's more maybe country as opposed to Southern style rock, but that was basically the one thing that I thought that we didn't get an awful lot of growing up in Boston. Then again, outside of those type of groups, I it's not like I really favor that brand of music. I really like 38 Special, right? But is this, you know, Molly Hatchet? Yeah, I mean, a couple of good songs, right? But, I mean, if you're on a road trip and you're listening to nothing but Molly Hatchet, I mean, after a couple of hours, aren't you ready to jump out of a moving vehicle? And what does Molly Hatchet have? Blackfoot? I don't know. Dickie Betts, though. What a career. 80 years of age. And, you know, after the Allman Brothers, he had the Dickie Betts Band. And, you know, I guess he was still wanted the tour, but he was really unable to do much after his stroke, which I believe was in 2018. All right, let's dedicate the rest of tonight's show to Dickie Betts. We'll give you some Allman Brothers music during our final hour. I also want to get to you. Let me take a peek. My goodness, the text line. It is burning up, and I love it. I expect it to be burning up. You got a lot of thoughts after Balky spoke today. You got a lot of thoughts after Doug Peterson spoke today. You got more thoughts after our conversation with Ryan Roberts talking about the NFL draft. I've given you my opinion. I'm going to reflect upon that a little bit for a new audience, but I think there's a chance they move up. I do. I think there's a chance they only move up a couple of spots, however, for a corner. I don't think any of that talk of getting into the top 10 for a wide receiver is going to happen. Your thoughts on this as well. 641-1010. That is the best way for you to get on in. That is our text line, which is brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures.
Intelligent sports talk with an attitude.
She loved
Hey, sorry.
That is awful.
It's a Jack speech at J1A.
You got me.
1010XL.
I did mumble one word.
You know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh, they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Pick and here, gang. It's time to spring into action and refresh your vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. From dry eyes and allergies causing irritation to cataracts blurring your vision, Bowden Eye can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit BowdenEye.com to schedule your consultation. Bowden Eye & Associates, keeping the First Coast focused.
Discover luxury on your terms at Randy Marion Cadillac in Jacksonville and drive away today in style.
Boasting North Florida's largest selection of Cadillacs, we have your dream car waiting.
Immerse yourself in the unparalleled power and the elegance of the all-new Cadillac Escalade V.
Or experience the future with the Cadillac Lyriq, redefining luxury electric vehicles.
Thanks to our exclusive offers, the luxury of the Cadillac is more obtainable than ever.
And rest assured, every Cadillac is backed by our dedication to outstanding customer service.
Randy Marion Cadillac, Southside Boulevard, Jacksonville. Tell them Jennifer sent you.
This is Keith Catlin for Catlin Truck Accessories, and we are so blessed to be in business for over 100 years. Over 100 years of the best product and customer service means you can count on Catlin. From rolling lock bed covers to Lear toppers to cam locker toolboxes, Catlin Truck Accessories has you covered when it comes to your truck or van. We do those too. Got a fleet of vehicles? We can outfit them all.
Who can you count on? Count on.
One name, one location, 100 years, you can count on Catlin.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. 904-274-5522.
If you're tired of your fence looking like a bad hair day, well, it's time for a fence makeover with Superior Fence and Rail. They'll make your yard the talk of the town with a new fence installed by their expert team.
Your fence is fantastic.
My fence is giving all of my neighbors some serious pick and envy. Thanks, Superior Fence and Rail.
So get off the fence and call Superior Fence and Rail for your fence installation project today.
SuperiorFenceandRail.com.
home of the Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Awaken 180 Weight Loss. Look, last week I recognized I had made a difference. No, it wasn't saving a puppy from a well or pulling an old lady out of a burning building. Remarkable as those would have been, this one was pretty cool as well. I saw a hacker and he was down 45 pounds thanks to Awaken 180, and it was awesome. Well, why was it awesome? Well, he thanked me for introducing him to Awaken 180. So I'm not only able to watch him have that same transformation that I had, but I know I had a bit part in helping someone make a 180 with their life, and it inspired me to continue sharing mine. From Matt Hayes to Hacker and hundreds of listeners, every story is uniquely inspiring. If you have questions, feel free to ask me about Awaken 180. I'm happy to answer all of them, and just maybe you will be the next Awaken 180 success story. Call Awaken 180 today at 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or schedule your consultation online at awaken180weightloss.com.
Man, it is a beautiful day to fish.
Here's your life jacket.
You know I can swim, right?
So could a lot of people who died falling overboard.
Come on, I'm not a kid.
Fatalities are often men over 30.
It's too hot to wear one.
These new ones are
They're happy. Ooh, I got one!
Glad you wore the life jacket.
Okay, yes.
Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission reminds you to wear your life jacket. Visit wearitflorida.com. Wear it, Florida.
1010XL is presented by Farrah and Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Let's go into the night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Yeah, this is not good right here. This woman just took off with one of his good friends at some crosstown bar. It's got a little bit of a Bob Seger feel to it, right? Seger's always running with the one that got away. But it felt like Seger would always, you know, maybe try to welcome that woman back at some point. Not here. After this song, it's like hit the bricks and don't look back. Dickie Betts, dead at 80. Of course, this is Greg, the great Greg Allman. I've never read a book on Dickie Betts. I don't know if there's one available. I did read the Greg Allman piece, My Cross to Bear, which I'm guessing came out, I don't know, 7, 8, 10 years ago. I don't remember exactly, but I enjoyed it. It was a really good piece. The biggest surprise today, one that I never knew or never dreamed would actually happen. As I said, we would go through a little bit of a lull here in golf until the PGA Championship. But Scottie Scheffler playing at Hilton Head? I mean, the story last week was like his wife was ready to pop at any given second. My goodness, what's going to happen if he's in the middle of his backswing and his beeper goes off and he says he's going to come home? He's playing the next week. He's out at Hilton Head. And today, a 2-under, a 68, 4 birdies, and a double bogey. But reportedly, he flew back to Dallas, you know, late Sunday night, was partying with buddies who he took with him to Augusta. They continued it at a dive bar in Dallas. And I guess he recovered on Tuesday, got to Hilton Head yesterday. And again, he is 2 out right now. This actually really is an impressive field. They're playing for $20 million at Harbortown Golf Links. $20 million. And on top right now, JT Poston at 8-under, a few at 6-under, including Colin Morikawa. But you just look at some of the higher-ranked golfers, if not where they presently sit with their rankings, certainly name recognition. You know, Patrick Cantlay, Jason Day, Rory McIlroy. Good round today for Rory, a 67. At 4-under. Again, Scottie Scheffler, JT, today with a 69. He's at 2-under par. Tony Finau, Sam Burns, So, again, a pretty good list here. Shane Lowry, Jordan Spieth, Ricky Fowler, all one-unders with 70s here on the par 71. Max Homa, Tommy Fleetwood, Matt Fitzpatrick, who won this tournament a year ago, Brian Harman, Justin Rose. I mean, it just goes on and on and on. Some of the higher-ranked golfers, Gary Woodland as well, plus two. Keegan Bradley, last place today, plus five of 76. So there you go. That's the latest there on golf. Did we miss that story? I thought she was ready to give labor during the Masters.
Yeah, the media loved that, and then later on they're like, oh, well, it's actually 3 weeks away.
Mm.
But this is one of the elevated events, so it's like the PGA thought, hey, what's good for ratings probably is like everyone's hyped on golf right after the Masters, and this weekend they're looking for something to do. Well, we have a great field. So I don't hate that thinking. Because usually no one, you know, worth a damn is going to be playing the week after the Masters unless they had a terrible week, didn't make the cut. You know, usually you don't see big names like that right away playing, especially not the guy who won. But you throw a $20 million purse and you're going to get everybody to play. And they have to play a certain amount of these events, right? There's like a percentage that all the big names have to, you know, I don't know what it is, but I know that they can't just skip all these events like they used to.
Only 69 golfers in the field for this event. How about Scotty Scheffler's caddy? And trust me, I'm getting back to football right after this. But Ted Scott.
Paid.
He's already earned $1.2 million this year. Okay? This calendar year. Okay, I'm not talking about when the season began, whenever it begins now. I guess it officially starts after the playoffs. You know, I kind of lose interest in this great sport once football is fully entrenched. But if you take the victory at Bay Hill, the victory here, the second place finish, and I believe it was Houston, and then a win a couple of days ago at Augusta National, his caddy has already made this year $1.2 million for Lupin, for the great Scotty Scheffler. So, all right, just to recap, Balky did say today that the board has not been finalized, that they will do that on Monday. Obviously, they've gone through their due diligence to putting everything together, but he said that, quote-unquote, he's not going to force it when moving up to try to get a player that he does covet. I still think there's an opportunity that they could move up. I really believe that, okay? Not into the top 10 to get a receiver, but I think up a couple of spots to maybe get a cornerback. The other part of all this is, again, the conversations continue, and it does. It feels somewhat genuine that this could actually get done with Trevor Lawrence any time now. And I'm really surprised by that. I don't understand the thinking. And let's be honest, the hurry. Make him play this year. Make him play year four under, what, 17.1 or is it 17? I think it might actually be 11.7. Let me look that up real quick for Trevor Lawrence because I know you're dying to know. Let's see, Trevor this year, yeah, 11.7. I think I said 17 earlier. If I did, I apologize. Okay, it's 11.7 is what he's playing for. You got an opportunity to do some really good things with a quarterback under a rookie salary structure. That's certainly the deal in Houston with C.J. Stroud, no doubt about it. But it does. It feels as though something could happen here with the Jaguars. And, you know, I would say before the regular season does, in fact, get underway. 0296 says, Baloo, when is the last time this organization drafted a wide receiver in the first few rounds for Trevor? Should have kept Williams so they could focus on a wide receiver. Well, it hasn't happened. You know, they didn't draft a wide receiver in 2021, which was Trent Baalke's first year. They drafted Jalen Camp in the sixth round, right? They did not draft a wide receiver in 2022. In 2023, they drafted Parker Washington in the sixth round. So in three drafts, you've got a seventh round. You got a couple of sixth round guys, one who didn't make it in Jalen Camp. I still think Parker Washington has a chance here. I do. And, you know, these new kick return rules, my guess would be he's going to be the guy next to Duvernay. I don't know that. That would be my guess. You know, we'll see. They could maybe address that again coming up in a week or certainly Friday or Saturday. But, you know, I think that is fair. And this organization has really never done well when it comes to drafting wide receivers. I mean, who's the last wide receiver who really was a difference maker around here? Yeah, DJ Chark had a good year. You know, Allen Hurns was undrafted, had a good year. Marquise Lee never really got it going. Allen Robinson had that great year with 1,400 yards, but there were injuries and it didn't work, right? And you can go all the way back to Justin Blackmon and R.J. Soward and Matt Jones and Reggie Williams. That's ages ago. I mean, that is forever. But it still lives in the memory of you Jaguar fans. I mean, this organization's only been around for 30 years. You're going to remember the moves that they made, and they really are. This is a snake bit organization when you look at who they have drafted wide receiver-wise. Who is the best wide receiver they've ever drafted? Honestly, who is it? Is it Allen Robinson? I don't even know where else you would go. It's fascinating.
Did they draft McCardell?
No, they got him and Jimmy.
Yeah, Jimmy, you know, was from Dallas. Right?
Right, he was let go. He had the major operation and was basically left on the street. Keenan McCardell was not a blockbuster signing. It was, in some circles, almost an afterthought.
Oh, yeah, he played on two teams before the Jags.
Right. DJ Chark. I mean, D.D. Westbrook. Look at these guys that they've selected. Rashard Green. How many times did we hear, Rashard Green's the best wide receiver in this building? Rashard Green was freaking phenomenal at Florida State. Phenomenal. Okay, I didn't see Sellers. I didn't see Biletnikoff. But ever since I was a freshman there at 87, if you would have asked me to rank the top wide receivers to ever play at Florida State that I saw, again, apologies to Biletnikoff and apologies to Sellers. I'm going to start with Peter Warwick. Rashard Green is number two. Okay? If you look at consistency and what he did through 4 years, including that national championship drive at the Rose Bowl, then I'd probably go Kez McCorvey, E.G. Green. You know, that would probably be my way. Kelvin Benjamin, even though that was spotty. You know, where else are you going to go? Javon Walker? I mean, Florida State doesn't – these guys don't make it to the NFL. How can Florida State not have wide receivers in the NFL? Are you kidding me? There's talent everywhere. I mean, Miami and Florida, they throw guys to the NFL almost yearly at wide receivers. Florida State's got no wide receivers at all in the NFL. Do they have any? Is there even one wide receiver in the NFL, presently speaking, out of Florida State? How can you miss? I know Lawrence Dossie was terrible, and I loved him. But there's a guy as a player should be in the top 10. He was part of that Fab Four, right? Ronnie Lewis and Terry Anthony and Bruce Hussein. It was a good group. And don't Lavernius Coles me. He was a running back at Florida State. At least he came in as a running back. Yeah, I don't know. But history tells us Trent Baalke's not going to draft a wide receiver. Look at his record in San Francisco, too. It's not impressive at that particular position. But when was the last time this organization invested a top pick to an offensive player and was successful? I guess Baalke is here to stay, but he hasn't done Trevor or this franchise any favors in the draft. It's the highest pick, Strange, in the second round. That's inexcusable. Well, Trevor and Travis have been good football players. They haven't been outstanding. Again, everyone listening is hoping that Lawrence's best football is ahead of him. I just think they haven't used ETN properly, right? And they used him too much. A lot of that based on the fact that Tank Bigsby really failed the year ago. And I'm on the Bigsby bandwagon for what it's worth. I think he's going to respond this year. I do. And I, you know, you have to give credit to the Anton Harrison pick. That was a good pick. And you know, let's play this real quick if we can, JJ. Let's play number, before the break here, let's play number eight because Peterson talked today, Doug Peterson now, about, you know, two guys who basically were on a redshirt season here in Jacksonville. They got nothing out of their fourth rounder, Ventrell Miller. They got nothing out of a seventh rounder in Cooper Hodges. Both could really come into play. I mean, how much longer is it going to work with Sheriff at right guard? And he's dealt with injuries. There's school of thought that Cooper Hodges could possibly be the right guard of your future. Remember, he's a seventh round pick. Ventrell Miller is a guy that I think is a fantastic football player. I mean, I loved watching him play at Florida. I thought he was all over the place. And with this new scheme coming in, and there's, you know, all the talks about Chad Muma is the next linebacker, right? Where does Ventrell Miller come into play in all of this? Doug Peterson today was asked about both players and the latest on them.
Both guys are doing extremely well. you know, both have been here rehabbing and did a nice job during the season to get themselves in a position to, you know, perform this spring. And you know, they're here in the building. They'll be able to get on the grass with us, you know, in phase two, and then obviously during OTAs in phase three, and it'll be a big opportunity for both those guys, because I thought at the end of camp both guys were really trending in the right direction for us, you know, to potentially help you know, so we'll see where they are, but they're healthy, they're ready to get back on the grass you know, see where we can plug them in and contribute, and again give us, as we talk about, give us the depth that we're looking for at both of those positions.
If you're a teacher and you're grading, okay, you give Anton Harrison an A. Brenton Strange is a D-. Tank Bigsby is a D. Ventrell Miller is an F. Tyler Lacy, a D. And I'm being kind. Yasir Abdullah, F. Right? So that's your first, your second, your third, both fourth-round picks, and your fifth. You got next to nothing. That's not to say that those players cannot produce this year. I think Brenton Strange is a good football player. I think the curve is pointing up for him. I've already told you about Tank Bigsby. I'm going to roll right on his bandwagon. I was on it massively a year ago at the Miller Electric Center. I'm going to go back. Ventrell Miller, I just told you. I love watching him play football. I think there's a chance. Tyler Lacy's got a phenomenal opportunity to increase his play snaps this year. Yasir Abdullah just feels odd. He's an undersized one-trick pony. I just don't think it works. Antonio Johnson's a starter. Parker Washington, I told you, I think there's a role. You know, I think he's probably the fourth or fifth wide receiver. It could be the fifth or sixth, but maybe a return guy. And then you look at some of these other guys. Can you get anything out of a Christian Braswell or an Eric Hallett? You know, as two guys with a little bit of experience, now learning a new regime defensively, and then the aforementioned Cooper Hodges selected in the seventh round. Ravel Hasek and Derek Parrish no longer a part of this organization. All right, we got much more to do. What a night over at the Blue Crab Crab. I'll tell you what, no place I'd rather be right here than Hogan Road. However, can you imagine right now, indoor, outdoor dining, beautiful night, starting to settle in a little bit. Yeah, I know it's starting to get hot. I got you. But whether it's crabs, whether it's clams, the very best in seafood located right off of San Jose, it's there on Julington Creek Road. Visit the good folks over at the Blue Crab Crab House. They're open every single day, except for Monday.
The team that loves the team you love.
They came together as a team.
1010XL, home of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Jamie Johnson, What a View Tour.
Like I'm playing the part.
The award-winning songwriting master. June 20th, the St. Augustine Amphitheater. Special guest Ben Haggard.
Should have seen it in color.
On sale Friday, 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com.
I tell you, the high cost of living.
Don't miss Jamie Johnson Live.
Still living high.
Are you embarrassed by your ugly, cracked concrete driveway? Need to enhance your home's curb appeal? StoneCore on Phillips Highway is your one-stop shop for all your outdoor needs. Replacing with new stone pavers will transform your driveway into a stunning work of art. Say goodbye to unsightly concrete and hello to beautiful, durable pavers that last for years. Visit StoneCore today and let's beautify your home together. StoneCore.co. We do outdoors better.
David Garrard here. Playing in the NFL can put a lot of wear and tear on your body, especially your knees. Southeast Orthopedic Specialist has kept me mobile and ready to tackle every day.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
David Garrard here. I've had the PRP treatment from Southeast Orthopedic Specialist, and my knees are really doing well. Platelet-rich plasma treatment may be the answer for whatever is hurting you.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time, in fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing, and it's serious, and it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th, bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena. Guns and Hoses.
Nothing came easy, and he wouldn't have it any other way.
It's blue-collar line-of-scrimmage football. I'm Tom McManus, and I join Jaguars Today, Fridays from 10 to noon.
Brought to you by Renewal by Anderson Windows and Doors on 1010XL.
Looking to make a great impression? Dylan Denmark here, folks, and when I want to score big, I send flowers or a plant from Jacksonville's best, Kuhn Flowers. Yeah, man, it's always a good thing to send someone a Kuhn floral arrangement. KuhnFlowers.com.
This is Hayes Carline for First Florida Credit Union. I bank with First Florida Credit Union because I trust them. I can always count on them when it comes to the vast services they provide. First Florida Credit Union was voted Best Bank in the 2023 Best of Bold City Community Choice Awards, and it's easy to see why. I go to the branch off 210 in St. Johns County and the new Durbin location, but they have 10 branches in the Jacksonville area. You need to be banking with First Florida Credit Union. They're enriching people every day. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Opportunity Lender.
Hacker here, and I'm loving the doors that are now opening now that I'm down almost 50 pounds. Oh, yeah, and those results are in just 7 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. By doors, I mean opportunities I've avoided because of my weight, like an all-day adventure to SeaWorld or spending 3 days at Walt Disney World. Did I gain the normal 5 to 10 pounds I would have at Disney? Of course not. In fact, I lost 3 pounds. Last week at Disney, thanks to the good folks at Awaken 180. Awaken 180 travels with you, and I'm eating all sorts of foods, salmon, ground beef, broccoli, cabbage, collard greens, you name it. It's not a lie when I say I'm eating to lose weight is the only way to lose weight. Do what we all did, Matt, Mike, and myself. Call Awaken 180 Weight Loss, 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or go online, awaken180weightloss.com.
Life isn't the same without live music. Players Grill Mandarin has Samuel Sanders performing covers and original music this Saturday at 8 p.m. Jam out with this local singer-songwriter while enjoying tasty food everyone can enjoy. Players Grill Mandarin, where the neighborhood meets.
Visionaries, builders, and doers, are you ready to change the world? Miller Electric is your opportunity to shape the future. Miller Electric is leading the charge in electric vehicle technology with our state-of-the-art EV Innovation Design Center. We're working to create a sustainable future. We're also the proud partners of the Jacksonville Jaguars, powering their performance at the brand-new Miller Electric Center. Miller Electric, we provide competitive pay, unbeatable benefits. Apply today. MillerCareers.com, Miller Electric, an equal opportunity employer.
Attention all business owners. The raining season is coming, and it's important to ensure that your property storm drains are free from debris and functioning properly. That's where DuckDuck Rooter comes in. Our powerful VACCON truck can effectively clean out your storm drains and prevent costly damage to your property from flooding. Don't let clogged storm drains ruin your business and reputation. Call DuckDuck Rooter today to schedule a cleaning before the rains hit. 904-862-6769 or online at DuckDuckRooter.com.
O'Reilly. Check engine light on? Take the guesswork out of your check engine light with O'Reilly Veriscan. It's free and provides a report with solutions based on over 650 million vehicle scans verified by ASE-certified master technicians. And if you need help, we can recommend a shop for you. Ask for O'Reilly Veriscan today.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
1 week from tonight, the NFL Draft, nonstop analysis until then of course after, but that's going to be a heck of a lot of fun. Jags at number 17. They moving up, they moving down, staying put. Is it a corner? Is it a wide receiver? Could it be a surprise pick? Could it be a pass rush end? Could it be an offensive lineman? I'd love it if it was an offensive lineman. I absolutely would. 4704 Blue, if Tavondre Sweat does fall to the third round, should you trade back into it to get him? Boy, Trent Baalke today was big on character. He was asked about it. I think to be clear, whenever anyone's asked about character, they're going to tell you that. I mean, wouldn't it be kind of cool? You're like, oh, I could care less if he's a bad guy, as long as he can play football. You're not going to hear that.
I prefer bad guys.
I think you know how I feel when it comes to them. I say it all the time. I think you need a cast of characters. I think you need a couple of guys on your football team. Which way am I trying to describe it? Almost as if you have eyes in the back of your head, right? What this kid did was wrong, but what this kid did, the whole world is done at one point in their life. Doesn't make it right, but should it cripple his career? And I understand a lot of you out there and how you think. I don't believe, this is just my guess now, I don't believe that any of you are going to be like, that's it, I'm done, I'm rescinding, you know, that's it. I'm not going to the games. They drafted this guy who got hit with a DWI. I just don't think, I don't think that that's in play for you. Maybe wrong, but I'd be surprised. That this kid, 6'3", 366, it's a huge move. All it takes is one team to make that particular move. And I just get the feeling that Jacksonville will not.
Now, did you see that? The real controversy and the real moment that's been going viral from Trent Baalke's press conference. I'm going to just play it. It's a short clip.
Okay. Still got a couple of days going through. Coach and I haven't sat down and gone through the final board yet.
Now, was that a fart?
What?
Going through. Coach and I haven't sat down and gone through the final board yet.
Did that happen?
Yeah.
I was sitting right there in the second row. How did I miss it?
Still got a couple of days going through. Coach and I haven't sat down and gone through the final.
Nice rip, Lantern. Wow, man. Let me tell you something right now. I have all new respect for Baalke. He's just like, listen, I'm the general manager of the team. I'm going to do whatever the hell I want, including this.
Now, that makes me think that he really is locked into 2025.
Right.
This guy's got all control, except of his bowels. I didn't remember hearing it when I cut up some of the audio, but maybe that was one that Gibby cut up. So But I'm glad you didn't smell it. So maybe it was just him moving in his chair. I don't know. But why would he say, excuse me?
Huh.
I love that.
Let me hear that one more time. Yeah. This will be short here.
A couple of days going through, Coach and I haven't sat down and gone through the final board yet.
God, that's a fart, dude. I mean, we both know farts. We all know farts.
All new respect for him.
Yeah.
Almost felt like it was uncontrollable, like something had happened, and I mean, there was just no denying it, you know? There was no way to get around it.
Yeah, so he just apologized. He manned up. I appreciate that. Listen, that's why a real man always claims his own.
Yeah.
No matter if it's in front of millions of people on the internet.
71-73 says Justin Blackman was by far the best wide receiver the Jags have ever drafted. He just happened to be an alcoholic. He would have been a Hall of Famer. He was that good. To this day, it's just mystifying to me what happened to him. And you know, I remember talking with Todd Monken. Frank and I were doing a show. Monken was here. Then he went back to Oak State and told us about he didn't run routes, that the ball's not coming to him. He didn't give him a glowing endorsement. Remember that interview that we did. But anyway, we will see. Getting a lot of people in here. Give me some stuff here now on Molly Hatchet. How I've missed the boat on Molly Hatchet. I think I'm okay with my opinion there.
By the way, we had a caller. He thinks it was a belch.
Really?
Still got a couple of days going through. Coach and I haven't sat down and gone through.
But he doesn't open his mouth, and it's very audible, and it sounds like a fart. Man, we need, like, the local Jax News. You know, those people that, like, show up to some sort of restaurant that's been, like, you know, serving bad food or something, or like some guy has been like, some landlord has been ripping people off, and like the local news comes in to investigate. We need that.
Yeah. No wonder I'm being asked to do so many radio shows in other markets on what Trent Baalke.
Yeah, exactly.
All it says is, can you join me to talk about Baalke? I hope it's not this. I hope this doesn't become like I'm on the, traveling circus. Oh, by the way, Dickie Betts, who died today at the age of 80, do you know he left high school in 16 and first joined the circus before he got up with Dwayne Allman?
At 16?
Wasn't aware of that until I read it earlier today. Hey, man, I saw it on the internet. It's got to be true.
I believe it.
No.
What is that, Vietnam?
Here's a guy, 4679. Here's a guy bringing up, hey, Baloo, did you forget about Randy Moss at Florida State? I didn't forget about Randy Moss. He never played it down at Florida State. He just never did. This is from the 6130. Hey, bud, unfortunately, you have fallen for the cover-up of Baalke and Peterson. They are just letting it out. They're interested in something other than what they really want to target and get. They want other teams to think this. Well, yeah, that's fine. Tomfoolery is fine. Gamemanship is fine. You don't expect them to come right out and say, we're going to draft a corner, we're going to draft a wide receiver, right? I just said a couple of minutes ago, I wouldn't be shocked if it was a defensive end. My money says it's going to be a corner, okay? If I was drafting, I'd draft the big wide receiver. Or I draft an offensive lineman. I've been crystal clear about this. I'm not going to get off it now. And, you know, we had Quadri Ismail on, who was just bragging about the way that Ronald Darby played this past year and hated the fact that they lost him. So maybe they're a little bit better served at corner than we know about. Maybe one of these younger guys can step up and help out. I don't know at this time. You've drafted a few of these players. I mean, over the last couple of years, if you had guys, when I mentioned Braswell and Hallett, if you bring up a Gregory Jr., Johnson's more of the you know, the safety nickel guy, nickel safety, that kind of surprised me as well, along with the Savage signing, depending on, you know, where, in fact, they're going to play him. But you look at some of those younger guys, all you really need is for one of them to step up and play. Yeah, the whole Deion thing. Yeah, you know what? I'm not going to get to that today. But I guess he's denying what he said about the six teams that his players would only play at. It was so stupid. When he was talking about his son, he was talking about Travis Hunter. There's only six. I mean, you talk about the ultimate karma and the ultimate jinx. Bro, it's mid-April. You still got another 4 months until college football begins. Or I guess what? You got May, June. Heck, it starts. It's 3 months. But how could you? Why would you do something like that? There's not a lot of things I believe in. I believe in karma. I do. And man, you're just really setting those players up for massive failure. It's like I'm kind of expecting season-ending injuries like the first week of September. You've presented this problem. This is on you. I mean, you're Deion. You're the greatest of all time. Shut your mouth if you're talking about he's only going to play for six teams. Now, I guess he denied this. But how does it get out anyway? How does something as foolish as that get out anyway? That you'd only allow your son and Travis Hunter, who he's known forever, to only play for six football organizations? I mean, I've been doing this forever. I've never heard that. We heard the Manning deal. You can go back to John Elway in Baltimore. You can go back to, you know, Bo Jackson in Tampa. There's been some stories, but nothing like this. All right, final break of the night. Come back, put our wraps on this one. Already looking forward to tomorrow's show. That'll be from 6 until 8. A little bit on Florida State tomorrow. Their final practice was today. All right, their big game coming up over the weekend. So we'll do that. Also, some more on college football coming up on Friday. And as well, the very latest on the Jaguars after today. It was an interesting one, hearing from both Trent Baalke and Doug Peterson.
May I have your attention, please?
Get ready for 1010XL's new primetime lineup. Start the day with Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser. Dempsey and Fat Tony take you to noon. It's the ladies of Helmets and Heels until 2. XL Primetime follows at 4. Franchi and Carline drive you home. Then Baloo and Hacker take you into the night.
It's showtime!
This is the sound of turning small bets into legendary wins. Only on the Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook app. The sound of parlays, the sound of paydays, the sound of watching the game will never be the same. Hard Rock Bet has already paid out millions and millions in parlays to people across Florida. Download Hard Rock Bet now, and if your first bet doesn't win, get up to $100 back as a bonus bet. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida, must be 21 plus and physically present in Florida to play. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMIT-IT.
Does the building you go to work in every day need a little love and attention? Jason Parker here with Performance Painting. Great companies take great care of the buildings their staff and customers walk into every day. If the building you're in doesn't match the vision you have for your company, we can help. Go to performance-painting.com. Our highly trained team makes the difference. Quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
Want to pay less to vacation more? General RV makes that possible and even more affordable during the model year closeout, April 17th through the 21st. 5 days of savings and free family activities with the best deals on travel trailers, motorhomes, fifth wheels, and more. Guaranteed. Get to the model year closeout where you can pay less to vacation more, just how you want it. Only at General RV in Orange Park on Wells Road off 295.
Keeping your body healthy and active leads to a more vibrant life. A great place to do that is the First Coast YMCA. The Y is equipped with state-of-the-art cardio and strength equipment.
plus group exercise studios where trainers host activities like yoga, Zumba, and cycling sessions. The full court basketball gym and indoor five-lane swimming pool are open year-round. The Kid Zone can keep an eye on your kids while you work on that dad bod. And it's all available with your family membership. Learn more at fcymca.org.
I love the smell of fresh draft picks in the morning.
What are Jacksonville's draft day options?
Tell us what you're thinking for our first pick.
1010XL's draft coverage is brought to you by Renewal by Anderson Windows and Doors, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
We love talking sports on 1010XL, and I-9 Sports love giving kids the perfect way to grow up playing sports. Summer and fall registration is underway, and if you log on to i9sports.com, you'll see all they've got to offer for kids 3 and up. And don't forget to enter 1010 in the promo code for a discount on registration. Year-round sports all across the First Coast, from St. John's, Duval to Clay. Summer and fall registration open right now. Fort Family Field in Westside Middle or online at i9sports.com. Get your kids in the game with I-9.
Who was the first baseball player to appear on a Wheaties box?
Having the right homeowner's policy protection means you're staying on top of your most valuable possession, your home. For information on finding an agent, go to southernoak.com.
Our family protecting yours, Southern Oak Insurance.
Lou Gehrig was the very first baseball player and athlete, for that matter, to appear on a Wheaties box. 1934.
Southern Oak Insurance, our family protecting yours.
Hey everybody, it's Mike Dempsey here for Pella Windows and Doors. Look, obviously the warmer temperatures are already here, and if you're like me, you want that oppressive Florida heat to stay outside your house. That's why I'm such a fan of Pella Windows and Doors. By now we know that windows are the number one way that heat gets in and the cold gets out. So when you're ready for the stylish design and energy efficiency that comes from Pella Windows and Doors, visit their showroom on Phillips Highway, just north of Bay Meadows, or you can always find them online at PellaJax.com. That's Pella Windows and Doors.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Bueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Let's go!
Looking for a night of action without a big hit to your bankroll? This Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena, cheer on your Sharks as they go all in against the Las Vegas Nighthawks. See what I did there? With tickets as low as $15, you can't find this kind of family affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com.
Let's go!
Decades night. Find that old members only jacket or favorite flannel shirt. We're celebrating the 90s. What's your favorite decade?
Let's go!
Don't miss the fun this Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena. For tickets, call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com. That's tickets at 904-621-0700.
Let's go! Let's go!
Ten XL is presented by Farrah and Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
All right, congratulations to Jaromir Jagr. Became the oldest player to ever play in a hockey game out in the Czech Republic at 52, broke the record of Gordie Howe. So, 52 years, 11 days, actually scored a goal. And he was something back in his career. No question about it. He just couldn't put the puck in the net that year with the Boston Bruins in the finals. Man, he hit the post several times. Just couldn't hit the back of the net. Hockey playoffs get set to start this weekend. That is going to be a blast. We got play-ins again in the NBA before the regular playoffs get underway as well this weekend. Of course, much more coming up on Friday on the NFL draft, plus some college football to bring in as well. Thank you to Ryan Roberts of RiseAndDraft.com. The producer is JJ LaSelva. My name is Rick Ballew. Hackers coming up right now. We'll talk again tomorrow at 6 o'clock in your home of the Jags.